Hi everyone, it's Sabine from Pengelin Photo Safaris. Welcome to another photo tutorial. And in this episode, I'm going to show you how I did edit this image of an African secretary bird. I've recently uploaded this image to my social media accounts, and I've received quite a few requests to replicate my edit process, which I'm going to show you in a moment in Adobe Lightroom. Before I get started though, please don't forget to subscribe to our Pengelin Photo Safaris channel by clicking the bell button below so that you get notified on our new videos coming out. Alright, let's get started. I have the image pulled up in my Lightroom develop mode. This one that you see here is the final version. However, I'm going to reset it now for our starting point. So usually in my editing workflow, I would start off with cropping the image. However, in this case, I've taken the image quite close and I don't want to lose any more of that beautiful colors in the sky. So I'm just going to leave the crop tool untouched this time. You can see that the picture is a little bit dark and I've purposely taken it like that because I did want to retain all those beautiful colors in the sky. Otherwise, I might have lost a little bit of the highlights. And I still have quite some detail in the bird itself. And I know since I'm shooting raw, it is quite easy in Adobe Lightroom to pull back those details, which I'm going to show you right now. So let's start off. Actually, I'm going to decrease the exposure even a little bit more to roughly about minus 15, just to get that bit more definition right in the sky. And then after, I'm going to lift my shadows up to plus 100, really to get back all the detail in the darker parts of the image. After that, I'm going to bring down my highlights roughly about to minus 60. That looks good. Brings out again, retains a bit more of the definition in the sky. And after that, I'm slightly going to increase my whites and my blacks just to bring back a bit more contrast, because at the moment, if you look at the image, it looks quite washed out. So let me bring up my whites slightly towards the right. About plus 30, I think, looks good. I don't want to go too far, because if I drag the whites up too far, the yellow-orange colors in the sky can very quickly look very oversaturated and too punchy. So I'm just going to leave it at about plus 30. That looks good. I take my blacks this time over to the left quite a bit. I really want to get a bit punchy contrast back in my image. Minus 50, yeah, that looks great. I'm going to leave the texture, clarity and dehaze sliders alone. In this case, I've taken this image with quite a high ISO of 1250. I do not want to increase or introduce any more noise into my picture. So I'm just going to leave the texture, clarity and dehaze slider to zero. I am going down, however, to my vibrance. I want to obviously bring out those beautiful colors. So I'm going to adjust my vibrance slider up to roughly plus 20. And often if I do increase my vibrance, what I do is I just slightly take away a bit of saturation, really just a slight amount, minus 2, just not to make it look fake or unreal. I want to stay as close to the original as possible. So that would be my adjustments in the main panel. Maybe I could adjust my white balance. If I look at the colors, the background looks really nice and I like the warm colors in the background. I don't really want to change those. But if I look at my bird, you can see that there's quite a bit of a yellowish tone to the white wings, underwings, and I don't really want that. So I'm just going to cool the overall image a little bit down. I will later on show you how I bring back the warmth in the sky. So I roughly bring that down to about, let's say, 5,200, somewhere in that range. That is good enough, 5,228, just to cool a little bit those whites down. The rest I do later with a local adjustment. All right, now I've finished my basic adjustments and I would like to do a little bit more of a local adjustment on my bird, onto the tree and in the background on the sky. So let's get into my adjustment brush. I'm going to choose my adjustment brush right up here. Always make sure you reset it to zero if it isn't already, just to make sure you don't have any funny things set from a previous brush that you used. And then I'm going to actually brush just over my bird, taking the adjustment brush and making sure that my auto mask is ticked. Auto mask helps you to mask out your subject, especially if the pixel, the color and the contrast of the pixel of your subject and the background, if they are quite different, then auto mask is really a great tool. So Lightroom helps you to really only paint on your subject and not accidentally painting onto your background. So I usually like to have that ticked. And then I'm going to just adjust the brush size a little bit and start brushing over my bird. To help see what you're actually brushing, it's useful to press O on your keyboard. O stands for overlay, and it gives you sort of a red coloration of the part that you are painting currently. So you can see exactly where you're affecting. And I'm just going to paint over, adjust my brush in between painting. If I get to smaller parts, the brush also needs to become smaller. And just quickly brush over. I'm not so concerned about the wing tips of my bird, so I'm going to leave those alone. Just those parts of the bird where I need a bit more detail. Maybe a bit the legs as well, decreasing my brush size once again. And just painting over. Making sure I get all these parts. And that is roughly the selection I want. That is good enough for me. Just also make sure that your feather is quite high so that it sort of blends in and is not a hard cut on whatever adjustments you make. I press O once again on my keyboard to get my view back to see what I'm actually doing. So what I want to do in this brush is I want to first of all lift the exposure. I want to bring back more detail on my bird. So I'm going to bring the exposure right up to, let's say about 50-ish. That looks good. I also want to change my temperature once again. I did that a little bit overall before already, cooling down the temperature. I'm going to do that now once again just on my bird. So I'm going to take my temperature slider down to minus 10, cooling down the whites, and you see the whites have gotten far more white than before. I'm also going to increase my whites roughly up to plus 30. Really make those whites a bit more white and punchy on the bird. And I also want to lift my overall shadows. So I'm going to bring up the shadows roughly to plus 15. That looks good. Getting a bit more detail in my bird's feathers once again. I'm happy with that, so I can get out of the brush. That already made quite a difference. However, I'm going to use a second brush once again, just a bit more specifically on the face of the bird and sort of here on the right hand side, that right wing going out, I think can do with a little more exposure. So once again, I choose another adjustment brush and I'm gonna lift the exposure once again before I've done it even and just brush slightly over the parts. I can see immediately how it's affecting this part of the bird. Even here a little bit on his chest, making that a bit brighter as well, and that looks good. If I want more, I can always dial in a little bit more exposure, and I'm happy with that. While I'm in the brush, I'm actually also going to use that to just lift up a little bit the tree where he's sitting on. I also feel that could be a little bit brighter, so I'm going to just choose a little bit of a bigger brush, make sure once again that my feather is quite high, which it is. And here I don't have to be very accurate with painting. I'm just going to roughly paint over the green tree, just bringing back a little bit more detail of the tree that he's sitting on. Maybe just some on the dark branches here. That's good. And perhaps right down here. And that is good enough for me. That just lifted the tree up a little bit as well. That already made a huge difference, brought out much more detail in the bird and the tree, which is my foreground. And now I'm going to attend towards my background, a beautiful sky. So I'm going to choose once more the adjustment brush, reset it to zero. And now what I'm actually going to do, I'm going to lower the size of my image. I go to my navigator up here on the side and I go to 1 to 16 view, which sort of gives me a very small preview of my picture. And I am going to adjust the size of my brush. I'm going to choose a really large brush with a very small feather this time. If you hover over the picture, you can see the brush is now covering the entire image. And I'm going to click on different parts on the background to select the different colors and try just to select a background without affecting my bird or the tree. So there we go. Again, if you can see, as soon as I press, there's a bit of a pinkish coloration, a reddish coloration going on. And as I press more, this does get stronger and stronger, which means all the colors in the background sort of being selected. But as you can see, most of my bird in the tree is not being selected. If I go to the full view, I can see slightly the underwing of my bird has been affected, which I do not want. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hold down the Alt key on my Mac. And you can see the brush has turned from a plus. As I press it again, you see it turns into a little minus sign, which then indicates whatever I'm brushing now, I'm going to take away again from my selection. I'm going to deselect. So that is exactly what I want to do here. I'm going to brush over the wing and make sure that my bird is not being selected, because I do not want to affect my bird. I just want to affect the background. Perfect. There we go. I'm going to press O on the keyboard so you can see the full image. And now I'm going to make the adjustments to my background. So as I said before, I would like to warm up the colors again as they were originally. So I'm going to take my temperature slider up to plus 15. That looks good. Bring some really nice colors into this lovely background. And what I'm also going to do is I'm actually going to apply some noise reduction to the background of this image. So I'm going to bring up the noise slider to roughly plus 50. And that will give me the desired result of getting rid of any noise that the background has. Another tool I sometimes like to use is the split toning. In this example, this can be very helpful. I can now adjust different colorations in the highlights or shadows of my image. In this case of the secretary bird, what I would like to do is cool down once again a little bit the dark parts, so the shadows, and I'm going to my shadow slider. If you hold down Alt on your keyboard, you get sort of a preview of what the coloration that will be introduced will be. And then you can just bring your slider towards the amount that you like. I think roughly about 214 is good. Nothing has happened yet. I've only chosen which color I would like to introduce into the image. And then after, you can choose of how much intensity you want. So I'm just going to bring up the saturation slider roughly to, let's say, plus 3. I think that is more than enough. It is a very subtle change, but that helps me just once again to cool down the feathers of the bird and also the tree itself, making it look a little bit more natural. As the last part in my editing process, I want to apply sharpening to my image. I'm heading down towards the detail panel for that. And as you can see here, there's already an amount of 40 applied to my image. But I do not want it to be applied to the entire image. I would like to mask out the part where I want the sharpening to be happening. For that, I'm going to hold down Alt on my keyboard while I drag the masking slider over to the right until I have a rough outline of my bird and the tree selected only. So what you see now, the white part in the image will be sharpened, the black in the background will be left alone, and it is exactly what I want. I'm just going to slightly increase the amount to about 50. I don't want to go overboard with the sharpening on this image, just because I've shot it quite dark and I've lifted up already lots of shadows and brightened up the image, which introduces quite a bit of noise. And if I further sharpen, I would just increase the noise even further. So 50 is just fine. I'm also going to actually apply some overall noise reduction, heading down towards my luminance slider under noise reduction, and bring that up to roughly about 8. that is good enough. Just to get a bit rid of the noise and the dark parts of the bird in the tree, the +8 will help me. So this is my final adjustments, the noise reduction. I'm happy with the look at the image. If I look at before and after holding the slash key on my keyboard, that is a great trick, so by the way, just to look in between how your image looked originally and with the edit steps that you did make. So it's sometimes just good to check that you see that you don't go overboard with your editing. And I'm very happy with this. I'm just gonna leave that as is. I'm gonna show you once more in full screen view. That is my final result. I really hope that you guys like the outcome. If you do have any questions, please leave them in the comments below and I'll get back to you. Have a great day and see you soon.